In this module, we're going to talk about strong acids and strong bases, what they are, and how to do a couple things with them. So first of all, what's a strong acid? It's one that essentially completely dissociates in water into a proton and its conjugate base. What this means is that even though there is a somewhat of an equilibrium, it lies so far to the right that we pretty much say it doesn't exist. I'll show you that in a second. But there are seven common strong acids that you should memorize. They are hydrochloric acid, hydrobromic, hydroiodic, nitric, chloric, perchloric, and sulfuric acid. Now, sulfuric acid is a diprotic acid. There's two acidic protons. Only the first proton is strongly acidic. Once this one of these hydrogen ions comes off, the second proton it's not a strong acid. That is, the hydrogen sulfate ion is not a strong acid. So nitric acid is one of those, is a strong acid. When we put it into water, there's a somewhat of an equilibrium, but the reverse equilibrium is so small, it's really immeasurable with our current technology. So we ignore it, justifiably so, and we only write a single arrow. And this is true for all strong acids. There's an inverse relationship, though, between the strength of an acid and how strong its conjugate base is. The stronger an acid is, the weaker its conjugate base. This is useful information. We'll see this particularly when we get into weak acids and weak bases. So this diagram explains that very well, I think. So a strong base. When you put a strong base into water, it essentially completely dissociates into the cation and the hydroxide ion. There are eight common strong bases: lithium hydroxide, sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, cesium hydroxide, rubidium hydroxide, calcium hydroxide, strontium hydroxide, and barium hydroxide. You should memorize these. These are pretty easy to memorize, though. They're all hydroxides, first of all. Second of all, they are the alkali metals: lithium, sodium, potassium, cesium, and rubidium, the stable ones. And three of the alkaline earth metals: calcium, strontium, and barium, with hydroxide. Water now. Water is kind of special. It can act as both an acid and a base. It's not a strong one, but it kind of fits in here. If you look at water, when you put, say, some acid, let's say hydrobromic acid in there, what happens is the hydrobromic acid donates its proton to the water molecule. The water molecule accepts that proton. That's being a base, right? We define that. And we make the hydronium ion and the conjugate base, the bromide ion. So in this scenario, in this situation, the water molecule is acting as a base. It's accepting a proton, a bronstitolary base. Now, if we put the methoxide ion, you guys haven't seen this yet, but it's a base, a strong base. It's basically methanol minus its proton. If we put the methoxide ion into water, the methoxide ion will pull a proton off of water, or we can say water will donate a proton to the methoxide ion, which will accept that proton. In that, and we make methanol, this is methanol, and the hydroxide ion. In this scenario, water is donating a proton, so it's being a base. So this is illustrating how water can be, how it is amphoteric. It can act as either an acid or a base, depending upon the situation. Now, when we have a strong acid, and it works equally well for a strong base in terms of the hydroxide ion, but the hydrogen ion concentration in a solution of a strong acid, it's just the same as the concentration of whatever the acid is. So for example, if we have a solution whose concentration of nitric acid is 0.0234 molar, let's calculate the pH, the concentration of hydroxide ion in there, and the pOH. And the key to this that makes this easy is that because nitric acid is a strong acid, if we know the concentration of nitric acid is 0.0234 molar, then we know that the concentration of hydrogen ion is 0.0234 molar. All right, so pause this for a second, see if you can calculate these guys, and come back and look what we did. All right, so hydrogen ion concentration is equal to the concentration of the acid. pH is negative log base 10 of the concentration of hydrogen ion. Plug it in, I get 1.631 for the pH. Hydroxide ion, remember, concentration of hydrogen ion times the concentration of hydroxide ion is equal to 1 times 10 to the minus 14th kW. And so if we rearrange that and solve for the hydroxide ion concentration by dividing by the dividing kW by the concentration of hydrogen ion, we get the concentration of hydroxide. In this case, 4.27 times 10 to the minus 13th molar. Once we know that guy, it's real easy to get the pOH, just negative log base 10 of the concentration of hydroxide, which I get 12.369. Note, alternatively, once you knew the pH, you could also find the pOH by taking 14 minus the pH, because remember, pH plus pOH is equal to 14.00.